Welcome to the ICGJC, the defenders of the faith. No, we don't back down. Niggas crapped and had Satan within. Then they got kicked out, now they talking they crap now. Can't escape hell, niggas took the cheese. Like a mouse on a trap, niggas making that rat sound. Open up their mouth, blasphemy coming out. AC unit, we about to react.
Niggas much for me to tell, niggas telling the tale. Gates of hell won't prevail, niggas going to hell. You a wicked rebel, nigga.
Shalom to everybody in the viewing audience. I'm Captain 13,000 Rakagabar, member of the Antichrist Unit. And right now, I'm going to do a response to an Antichrist named Miguel. The pride of the devil has gotten into this guy, Miguel, and he really believes he's some kind of big shot. He thinks that he's on some kind of level and we not. And he's been making some stupid videos that we're going to have to chop up and bring this cat down to realize he's nobody. So let's start off talking about what he was saying about our channel, ICGJC-Official ACU. He's talking like we're some kind of small fry and he's some kind of big shot. But let's make this clear. The fact that you're even talking about our channel is showing that our channel is doing its job. The fact of the matter is, when we put up content, it's to defend the faith. So your argument about how many views we get and how many subscribers we got, it's never really about that to us. What it's about is the truth. And what you're saying is really not that important. But in addition to it also being not very important, it's also wrong. And since you chose to get up and put your lies out there, now we're gonna confront you with the truth. And I want what you're really gonna have to say in response to what we about to show. You're talking like you're some kind of big shot, as if you have some kind of great following and we're not on your level, but actually that's false. There's a website that measures metrics of channels. It's called Social Blade. And according to Social Blade, we're gonna put this up on the screen, your channel is a C plus channel. That's not that impressive, is it, Miguel? Because you've posted more videos than us for longer than us, and all you've achieved is the grade of a C plus. Now, let's look at our channel. Our channel also has a C plus ranking. And that's despite the fact that we haven't posted as much videos as you. That means that we've already matched you in a short period of time. What this data is showing is that our channel and what we're doing on our channel is more impressive than what you've been doing for years. Now, Am I not reading this correctly? Let's take a look at the analytics, shall we, Miguel? Look at your subscriber chart and look at your views chart. Your channel has been declining and has declined greatly. It's never gotten to where it was before. And we're gonna talk about where it was before in a second. Our channel is picking up and is currently outdoing your channel. So what's going on, Miguel? I thought you was a big shot. I thought you were on some kind of level. How is it that we're outdoing your channel? You see, the truth is your channel was never really doing anything in the first place. When we look closely at the data, we see exactly where your views and your subscriber count came from. This is a disclaimer. No one should be watching any Antichrist videos and nobody should be going on their channels. The Antichrist Unit is set up to do this so that you don't have to. On your channel, your most viewed video is Dave Chappelle attacked on stage. It has 2.4 million views. Now, if we go to your channel and click on the video, there's no commentary from you. It's the exact video that was on TMZ's website. The TMZ watermark is still in the video. So this video was stolen from TMZ about Dave Chappelle, an issue that was going viral when he was attacked on stage. You posted it and people watched it, not because they wanted to hear from you. They wanted to see what happened to Dave Chappelle. And you want to talk about clout chasing? You were clout chasing Dave Chappelle. You stole a viral video and put it on your channel. That's all you did. And you're talking as if you're some kind of big shot. You posted this on May 4th, 2022. Now let's go back to Social Blade and check this out. If you go to Social Blade and look at the first spike that happened in the subscriber count, it happened on May 2022. What is this showing you? This is showing you that these people subscribe to his channel after seeing the Dave Chappelle video. That's the reason why you got a huge bump in your numbers and a huge bump in your subscriber count. Not because people care about what you have to say, not because you're some kind of well-known content creator. It's because you stole Dave Chappelle's video.
Boy, ain't no f***ing way, boy. Boy, ain't no way, boy.
You stole TMZ's video. And now, Social Blade is also showing that you have some other videos that got a lot of views. What are these? Well, these are your shorts. You stole someone else's TikTok video and put it on your channel. And you stole a
Walmart
news report.
Walmart is closing half of its stores in Chicago, saying they haven't been profitable in 17 years and lose millions of dollars a year.
It's like they're trying to starve the black neighborhood or something. I don't know what's going on because it's always crowded every time you come up here.
Mayor Lightfoot calls the decision disappointing. In a statement released today, she wrote in part, unceremoniously abandoning these neighborhoods will create barriers to basic needs for thousands of residents.
Now, whose fault is that?
And it got a whole bunch of views. And that's what these spikes are on the chart. So, what does all this mean? What this actually means for the people that understand how this works is that you, Miguel, you have an inflated channel. It means that you don't have a real audience. It means that the people who subscribe to you do not watch your videos. That's why when you post a new video, a video that you didn't steal from Dave Chappelle, you don't get 9,000 people watching it, even though you have 9,000 subscribers. Let's look at your latest videos that aren't about us. That's not about the Israelite Church of God and Jesus Christ. Your Carly Russell video got 66 views. Your 2023 mass shootings video got 123 views. But you claiming that we are the lowest of what you'll get views on if you talk about us. That's not what the numbers show. That means that you need us. We don't need you. You're trying to make fun of our 600 subscriber count, but we have more than 600 people watching our videos. Our videos are actually getting thousands of views, and they haven't even been out for that long. So, our videos with 600 subscribers are getting views than you are with 9,000 subscribers. Are you following us, Miguel? Do you really? I know you're stupid, but is it getting to you yet? What that means is we have a bigger audience than you. And it also means that we have a real audience and you don't. Our audience is bigger than your audience. And just after 3 months. So you don't know what you're talking about, Miguel. You're not qualified to critique us. People really want to hear what we have to say. You know why? Because we're teaching the truth. Because what we speak is the word of God. The glory goes to God. So it makes no sense for you to try to talk about us as if we're some kind of small fry. If you didn't steal people's videos, your channel would be an F. And it makes even less sense for you to ask why we need to go live with you on your channel about anything. We're not gonna resuscitate your dead channel for you. Look at this chart right here. You see that flat line right here? This is death right here. If this was a person's pulse, they'd be dead. That's a flat line. That means that person's about to die. They're not coming back. Your channel is dead, Miguel. So no, there's no need for us to go and shock some life back into your channel. And then on top of that, you're the last person that should be even talking about going live. Because when the God Sent Comforter had a live call-in radio show, you ran like hell. We know you were on the call. And we know you were too scared to be a man and stand up behind all that garbage that you talk. You were a coward and we witnessed it live. Then you tried to lie the next day and act like you weren't even on the call. Yes, you were. You're pathetic. And your little channel is pathetic. When the Holy God sent Comforter, Holy Apostle and Chief High Priest Hazadakia did his radio show, he just announced it. And just after that, when he did the show, thousands of people was on the call, including you demons. He didn't have to sit there waiting for people to log on and asking people to come in, I want to start, come in. The nerve of this guy is crazy. Then he starts trying to critique us about the scriptures. First of all, fool, we believe in God. You don't. We believe in the entire Bible. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus. We believe in all the laws of God. We don't have a problem with wearing fringes on our garments. We keep the law. We don't have a problem with keeping the Sabbath day holy because we're the true church of God and you're nothing but an antichrist and an atheist. When you're trying to back down from that right now, you had someone calling you out on your channel about why you don't believe in God, and you're trying to give some stupid answer. And you're trying to... you're actually trying to challenge us about what an antichrist is, as if we haven't broken this down plenty of times over and over. And as if we also didn't show a video exposing that you guys know what the antichrist is, or you have referred to yourselves as antichrist. And now you're coming back with this, Miguel? Well, since you want to bring it up, let's show someone else in your group that did it. Yes, you was a part of the same group with the Unjust League that was so-called trying to heal from your so-called experience in the church. And we know what happened with that group. You all started fighting and arguing with each other and cursing each other out like hell in that group. But nevertheless, since you want to bring it up, we know that you are one of those guys that was plotting with the Unjust League in their demonic Facebook group. That's you right here in the group. And they also invited this demon into their group. Now, watch what this demon says.
Remember back in 2015 when he had the... when he invited the Antichrist to come on his radio show and ask him any question we had.
Did you hear what he said? He said that the God sent Comforter invited the Antichrist on his show. And then his words are to ask him any question that we had. You guys have got to be the stupidest people on the planet. So what is he saying right there? He's saying that the Antichrist, singular, like you said, was on the radio show and he used the word we, which included himself, which included you, which included the Unjust League, which included everybody that went out from us, just like the scripture said. So he didn't actually mean to validate what we were saying. He didn't actually mean to do this. It slipped out. But that's what always happens with you guys, because deep inside, you know it's the truth. You know you're the Antichrist. You know it, and we know it. Now, let's take a look at this. Let me ask you a question, Miguel. Why are you trying to run from the fact that you are Antichrist? And how is this clown an Antichrist, but you aren't? Both of you left the church. Both of you turned against the truth. Both of you blasphemed the Holy Spirit. Both of you speak against God. Both of you are atheists. How are you not an Antichrist like him? And how are you not a traitor, Miguel? Miguel had the nerve to say that the 12 apostles would have been considered traitors to the Pharisees. So, you know, this is the mind of a rebel. This is the mind of an antichrist. They can't just deal with what the scriptures say. They always got to find some way to argue and justify themselves to make themselves, because they don't want to accept that they are the devil. But that's not what the scriptures say. You don't know what the hell you're talking about. I know you got that break, that false understanding from the Unjust League. And none of y'all don't know nothing over there. First of all, the apostles were called the followers of Christ. The apostles were following our Lord, King, and Savior, Jesus Christ, first and foremost. And what did the Pharisees say about our Lord, King, and Savior, Jesus Christ? They knew he was the heir. They knew he was the chosen one. That's what Matthew, the 21st chapter, tells you, if you knew the scriptures and you knew what you was talking about. Let's read Matthew 21. And we can read from verse 33 on down. It says, "Hear another parable. There was a certain householder," that's God the Father, "which planted a vineyard," which is the nation of Israel, "and hedged it about, and digged a winepress in it, and built a tower, and let it out to husbandmen." The husbandmen were the Pharisees, Sadducees, Levi, the priest that was supposed to be in charge of watching, of taking care of the nation. "But when the time of the fruit drew near, he sent his servants to the husbandmen that they might receive the fruits of it." So the servants was the prophets. "And the husbandman took his servants and beat one and killed another and stoned another." They killed the prophets. "Again, he sent other servants more than the first, and they did unto them likewise. But last of all, he sent unto them his son, saying, they will reverence my son." So the last one that was sent was our Lord, King, and Savior, Jesus Christ. Verse 38, "But when the husbandmen saw the son, they said among themselves, this is the heir. Come, let us kill him and let us seize on his inheritance. And they caught him and cast him out of the vineyard and slew him." Okay, so they killed our Lord, King, and Savior, Jesus Christ. Okay, it says, "When the Lord therefore of the vineyard cometh, what will he do unto those husbandmen? They say unto him, he will miserably destroy those wicked men, and will let out his vineyard to other husbandmen, which shall render him the fruits in their seasons." So what was their answer? Their answer was, they knew that God was going to take the nation of Israel away from them. Their priesthood was going to come to an end and was going to be given to someone else to get the fruits that God wanted. Verse 42, "Jesus saith unto them, did you never read in the scriptures, the stone which the builders rejected, the same is become the head of the corner? This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. Therefore I say unto you, the kingdom of God shall be taken from you, and given to a nation, bringing forth the fruits thereof." Now this is very important. Verse 43 again. "Therefore I say unto you, the kingdom of God shall be taken from you." The kingdom of God is the nation of Israel. You can read Matthew chapter 11, verse 12, which says, "And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffereth violence, and the violent take it by force." The kingdom of heaven that was suffering violence is the nation of Israel. The violent that was taking it by force was the Roman Empire, which had us in captivity, which was doing acts of violence to the nation of Israel. So, back to Matthew 23, verse 43. "Therefore I say unto you, the kingdom of God shall be taken from you and given to a nation, bringing forth the fruits thereof." It said that the nation of Israel was going to be taken from them and given to a nation, bringing forth the fruits thereof. "And whosoever shall fall on this stone shall be broken, but on whomsoever it shall fall, it will grind him to powder." Verse 45. "And when the chief priests and Pharisees had heard his parables, they perceived he spake of them." So they knew what? They knew that their priesthood was coming to an end and that a new righteous order was being set up. The Israelite Church of God and Jesus Christ, underneath the apostleship that was set up by our Lord, King, and Savior, Jesus Christ. No, they didn't think the apostles were traitors. They knew that Christ was the heir. They knew that they were the wicked men and that the apostles were ordained by God to replace them. The same way that you know that you are the wicked and that we are the ones that God ordained. That's what's going on right here. There is no verse where the apostles were ever called traitors, you lying demon. You clowns don't know the Bible. Stop trying to get breakdowns from the unjust league. Louis don't know nothing. Jerome don't know nothing. That other guy, I don't know why he's even up there, don't know nothing. None of them know anything. And when it comes to the prophecies of the Holy God said Comforter, you're not fooling nobody, man. They have been coming to pass and are still coming to pass. And we've already addressed a lot of your nonsense in our videos. It's already up on our channel. You need to read up on stuff before you start talking crap, because the videos are on our channel. And it's also on our other channel called Christlike. But we can make it clearer so there's no way for you to get around it. We are the Church of God, the Israelite Church of God and Jesus Christ. The real Church of God. That means we are in the Lord. And that brings me to the last thing that I want to talk about. Because you're making videos talking about how this person passed away, how that woman passed away, how this person passed away, as an attack. Like that's supposed to shake somebody over here. We're not shook by nothing that you say, because we have an understanding that you don't. This is Revelation chapter 14, verse 13. It says, "And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, Write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord from henceforth. Yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labors, and their works do follow them." That's why we're not worried about what you're saying, because we know that the people that have passed away in the truth are blessed. You think we're going to hang our heads down low because of your stupid insults? Your insults don't mean nothing. You're talking about what's the difference between people that passed away in the church and the Antichrist that passed away. How come it's one way when the Antichrist passed away and it's another way when the people in the church passed away? Because the people in the church, the Bible says their works do follow them and they rest from their labors. But what happens to you all when you pass away? 2 Ezra chapter 9. 2 Ezra chapter 9, verse 9 to 12. It says, "Then shall they be in pitiful case, which now have abused my ways," right? Like not remembering the Sabbath to keep it holy, right? "That and they that have cast them away despitefully shall dwell in torments. For such as in their life have received benefits and have not known me, and they that have loathed my law," oh, I don't believe in Leviticus, I don't believe in Numbers, I don't think people should be wearing fringes, I don't see the morality in it. "And they that have loathed my law while they had yet liberty, and when that place of repentance was open unto them, understood not, but despised it." That's talking about you. "The same must know it after death by pain." So you have the ones that actually followed the Lord that's going to be able to rest, because the works that they did is going to follow them. And they're going to be able to be with the Lord in the kingdom of heaven. But you and all the other people like you, that's the difference between us and you. You going to dwell in torments and receive punishment and pain, just like how the scripture said. So we're going to end it off there, Miguel. Please stop trying to come at us with scriptures. You don't know what you're talking about. To all the believers that's listened to this, it's the Antichrist Unit, man. Stay strong in the faith and don't let nothing that these clowns are saying shake you. Peace.
Couldn't settle, nigga. St. John 666, roll with the devil, nigga. Let me break down these fake clowns who sit inside a class and will take down breakdowns. Pen, paper, the sheet, holy comforter speak. Each verse he would teach you, eat spiritual meat. Gotta do the feast, the holy comforter lead you. Judas and you niggas betray the hand that feed you. And how low you niggas a rock? Go on side with the government, you think you a cop? Got dirt for brain, niggas smart as a rock. It's the truth when you win it, but it ain't when you not. Trading. When it comes to the ICGJC.